tried the Thai iced tea one. So
okay,
that
ladies.
Sounds good flavors.
Why don't we go ahead and we will start off seated. Actually, let's start off on our backs today. And we'll set some intention before the start of practice. All right, so one hand on our chest and one hand on our bellies. And then let's just come into our breath today. So on the full moon, we usually do it on the new moon, right? We set our intention essentially for the cycle. So thinking about what your intention is for this class and what we're thinking about doing in terms of the release, right? So thinking about one thing that you would like to receive in this moon cycle, one thing that you would like to give, and one thing that you would like to release. Letting the earth beneath you receive you. Don't spend a whole lot of time giving a lot of love back to the earth, or even really even recognizing her in the space of the way that she supports us, right? Every day. Regardless of space or elevation, she's always here for us. Where we can all come together as women and as men, right? Remember that men hold divine femininity within them as well. So we come into this space so we can tap into that part of ourselves a little bit more deeply. Big breaths. And exhale. Really reach this last time. So axial extension, everything from your hips down is coming towards me. Everything from your hips up is really extending up towards Mount Sentinel. So find that space right in your midline. And then exhale, you can move your hands back over top of you and then down to your sides. Maybe bringing a little bit. back and forth, side to side, through your ankles. And then when you're ready, you can go ahead and roll over to your left hand side, because that's our lunar. Okay. So keeping this in mind too, when you sleep at night or anytime that you're kind of like just relaxing, you need to draw in more feminine energy. You feel like you're lacking in that space. Lay on your left hand side. You need to draw more masculine energy into your space. You want to go ahead and lay on your right hand side. Okay? So nice deep inhales. And exhale. One more time. Nice deep inhale. And exhale. When you're ready, you can slowly go ahead and push yourselves up to a simple seated posture. Before we start for the full flow, I just wanted to let everyone know that my outfit today is from Athleta. Strength of our hands to pull ourselves into the posture. Big inhale here. Exhale, hold. One more time, big inhale. Exhale, we pull ourselves back to center. Hands come down, heart center. Nice soft knees on our fingertips again. And then inhale, we reach our arms back up. We interlock our fingers the opposite way this time, so the uncomfortable grip. A little bit of brain power. I like it every time now. But when we, even the little things that we do with our bodies, it gets our brains thinking on that opposite side, right? The side we don't usually use. Nice deep inhale. Then on our exhale, we pull ourselves over to the opposite side again. Big inhale. Exhale, belly button pulls in towards our spine. We let ourselves pull over just a little bit more. And then inhale, we bring ourselves back up. Up and out of our waist, and then on our exhale, we bring ourselves over to that opposite side, rolling open through our chest, big inhale, exhale, hold, one more time, big inhale, exhale, hands and body come to center, hands move down, heart center, hands come out in front of us, and then we're going to our fingers to just pull us over the top part of our legs. So we pull in hard on our low belly. in between our biceps or our shoulders.
So our belly button is pulling back towards our spines to create some compression. Big inhale. And exhale. Two more big breaths. And on every inhale, our fingers creep out a little bit more into the grass. And then on every exhale, we pull back through our hips a little bit more. One more time, big inhale.
And then exhale, we slowly walk our hands back towards our legs. We rock back on our sit bones, change the cross of our feet. Sitting up nice and tall, same thing. So again, use your fingertips to be the thing that pulls you out. I like to practice outside in the grass because you start to realize how strong the grass is, right? You can actually like really pull on it and not like rip it, break it, right? Nice deep inhale, belly button pulls in. Exhale. Inhale, hands walk out in front of us just a little bit more. And exhale, we pull back on our belly button just a little bit more. Sit bones are still trying to connect to the earth. And then exhale, we slowly walk our hands back towards our legs. We're gonna go ahead and take our feet out in front of us. Hands are gonna come back behind us. Fingertips are pointed away from us first to start. Take your biceps and bring them underneath, like your shoulders here, and then pop up through the chest. Make sure your thumb is engaged, okay? Nice deep inhale. Take your breath and pull it all the way up your belly into the top part of your chest. And then exhale. Keep a little mini micro bend in the elbows. One more time, big inhale. And then exhale, slowly bring yourself up a little bit and then flip your palms so your fingers point back towards your glutes. Again, little mini micro bend, press up through the chest, big inhale. Exhale. One more time, big inhale. And then exhale, slowly. We're gonna bring ourselves into a boat, so feet come up. You can always have your hands here. If you need a little bit more support, your feet, your hands can come right underneath your calves. Big inhale here. We're gonna tap down with our right foot and lift up. Tap down with our left foot and lift up. For five, four, three, two, one, and one more time. Big inhale here. And we'll slowly rock over your knees isn't an option. You just kick your feet out to the side and meet us in tabletop. So in tabletop, hands are spread nice and wide. Knees are right underneath our hips. Ground down into the earth. I always like to say, like, you could break a sweat in tabletop if you wanted to, okay? So you press down through your palms, press down through the tops of the feet and the shins. Nice deep inhale. Exhale. Inhale, we're going to bring our chest forward, and then our tailbone is going to come up towards the sky, coming into cow. Low belly hangs heavy. Exhale, press hard down into the earth, pull in on the low belly, head hangs super heavy. Inhale, chest comes forward again. Exhale, press and push. Last one. Inhale, chest comes forward. Exhale. Inhale, we bring ourselves right back into tabletop. Knees come wide, big toes come together to touch. We're going to press back into a child's pose. Hands come out in front of us again. Third eye, forehead
comes down to the mat and to the earth. So again on this one, you can use the strength of your fingertips to pull yourself out. So you can still try to roll your shoulders down your back though. So making your shoulders flush, or your shoulder blades flush to your back. Nice deep inhale. And exhale, hold. One more time, nice deep inhale. And then exhale. exhale, we're going to go ahead and walk our hands off to the left-hand side. Right hand comes on top of our left hand. I like to weave my fingers in between, so my right hand in between my left. So there's that space where you can kind of like give your hand a nice little massage, and then you pull back through that right hip, right? So create the resistance in your own body. Nice deep inhale. And exhale. One more time. Big inhale. And then exhale. Let's keep our chest low. We're going to walk through center and then bring ourselves over to that opposite side. Left hand comes on top of our right hand. We pull back through that hip. And again, our biceps can cradle our ears in this. Nice deep inhale. So breathing into our rib cage and that side body. And then exhale, we bring ourselves back through center. Inhale, one more time. Fingers creep out in front of us. Exhale, we pull back through our hips. Thinking about relaxing and releasing in the tops of our thighs. The more I get into yoga, the more I always think it's one body part that I have to blame, and then it's like something totally different. I'm like, oh, it's my hips. No, it's actually my hamstring, right? So pay attention to where you're holding and think about that place of release. Nice deep inhale. And then on our exhale, we're going to go ahead and pull ourselves forward. Bring our knees right underneath our hips. And then go ahead and just step back. And we'll bring ourselves into a forearm plank. If that's too much on your shoulder level, you can always drop down to your knees, okay? Nice deep inhale. Press back through the heels. And exhale. Think about trying to zip your elbows in just a little bit more. Big inhale. And then exhale. And then go ahead and just take two small steps and bring your hips up high, coming into dolphin. Nice deep inhale here. And exhale. One more time. Big inhale. Our down dog. Hands spread nice and wide, hips are high. So first down dog of the evening, go ahead and just roll out the tops of your feet. I like to say this is where we kind of come into our own flow. So figure out what you want to do with your hips. Figure out where you might be holding in the tops of your thighs. Paying attention to your body and your body only. Deep inhale and exhale. When we're ready, we'll just slowly baby step our feet up to meet our hands, holding ourselves here in a rag doll. You can put a nice big bend in your knees, letting head hang nice and heavy, grabbing for opposite elbows, and then go ahead and just sway back and forth, side to side. Low belly is still pulling in, so belly button tries to pull up and in towards our spine, and we do that to protect our low backs. Our spine, and then slowly we raise ourselves up to standing. Exhale, hands come down and move through heart center. Inhale, arms sweep up. Exhale, ground down. One more time. Inhale, arms sweep up overhead. Interlock your fingers like we did when we were seated. Go ahead and reach up out of the waist again, right?
So I think a lot of times we have a tendency in standing postures to grip with our butts like this. Just think about like hips like releasing and spreading. The tightness comes from here, right? My girlfriends like call it like your yoni space, right? So you like pull up through center line, right? That space of like infinite, okay? Nice deep inhale. And then on our exhale, we're slowly gonna rock ourselves over to the right hand side. Big inhale here. So thinking about taking that right armpit towards me and that left hip towards me to straighten out. Big inhale here. Exhale. One more time, big inhale. And then exhale, we bring ourselves back to center. And then we're gonna go ahead and step our right foot out. Bringing ourselves into a goddess squat. So in goddess, you just wanna make sure that your knees are pointed directly over your toes. And again, sometimes I have a pelvic tilt, so I'm always like, right? It's like a horse rein, you're always here, right? So again, thinking about relaxing and releasing here, but you pull in here. And then you just kind of like rearrange your feet to make sure that you can kind of be in that space, right? And it's, you can kind of do a nice like little shuffle here, okay? And then inhale, we come up. Exhale, we squat. Inhale up. Exhale, squat. We go for 10. For 9. For 8. For 7. For 6. For 5. Last 4. Last 3. Last 2. And 1. Hold here. Big inhale. And then let's go ahead, turn your toes in, and we're going to bring ourselves, again, pull in on low belly, bring ourselves down and over, coming into a wide angled forward fold. Nice deep inhale. Sorry. And exhale. One more time, nice deep inhale. And then when we're ready, ladies, we're going to go ahead and bring ourselves back up. We're going to turn out with our right foot. And we're going to just make sure that our feet are lined up so our heels are in a nice straight line. Back foot is going to be at a 45 degree angle.
Straightening our legs in this one is that you press down through your feet and lift your hips. You're trying to think about keeping your weight equally distributed across both feet though. Nice deep inhale. And then exhale. We're going to go ahead and just pop that foot back behind us a little bit more to bring ourselves into a runner's lunge. I like you just the way you are now. Over those toes, press back out through your heel. Don't pray for me. Dropping that back knee down to the mat and flipping your toe flat. I did this on my own and I got this far now. And exhale. And I'll get higher with it. And exhale.
has been written by men and it's for written for boys' bodies. Stay so it's something to bring out more. Okay. Nice deep inhale. I see the inner you and it hurts to let go. Exhale. We're gonna go ahead and bring ourselves. Go ahead and heel toe your feet in. Don't wait for me. We're gonna come into balasana squat. So elbows come to the inside of our thighs. Hands come to our heart center. And then you tilt yourself down. Here. Check in with your knees to make sure. So you can bring your feet in more. That's okay. Nice. Bend down that. Kind of like shift back and forth in this one. Just to let you know. Chins, I win. Okay, so big compression with chin against chest. It helps create some compression on our thyroid, which helps us with our digestion. So it's not comfortable. It's not meant to be comfortable. And you can put as much of a bend in your knee as you need to, but try to keep your chin to your chest and your forehead. Exhale. One more time. Big inhale. And then exhale. We can slowly raise ourselves back up. Pop that foot back behind. Extending here. And then triangle on this side. Hand comes down to chin. Hand comes up to the sky. Big inhale. Big breaths here. Big inhale. And exhale. Last one. Big inhale. And then exhale. Slowly bring ourselves back up. Go ahead and come into that wide angle. Toes turn towards one another. Big inhale. Exhale. We bring ourselves down and over the tops of our legs. Leading with our hearts to come down to the earth. And then again, you can shift back and forth a little bit to kind of open up your hips. Think about trying to pull the forehead down to the mat. Nice deep inhale. And think about rocking forward into toes. Feel like the balls of your feet, but drive down through your heels. Nice deep inhale. And exhale. And then on our next inhale, we're going to slowly bring ourselves back up. Toes slip out. We're going to bring ourselves back into that goddess posture. Inhale, we bring ourselves up. And exhale, we squat down. Inhale, exhale. and we'll just heel toes together. Interlock your fingers the opposite way we did last time. Reach up to the sky. And then we slowly drag ourselves over to the opposite side. Inhale, we bring ourselves back up. Same thing again. One more lunar flow. Actually, we'll do a little sun A to balance it out, because I'm not gonna totally shit on men. Inhale, arms come up overhead. Exhale, we bring ourselves down and over the tops of our thighs. Inhale, hands to shins, head sails forward, tailbone sails back. Exhale, hands come down to our mats. We step back into a plank. Big inhale. Press back through heels, holding here, big inhale. Exhale, lower ourselves slowly all the way down to our chest. Toes flip flat, hands are right next to our bust line, elbows staying close to our side body. And then inhale, we peel our chest up off the mat. We don't come up any higher than our belly buttons. Tops of our feet, press flat into the mat. Take your shoulders away from your ears. Big inhale, yeah. Exhale, hold. One more time, big inhale. Exhale, we bring ourselves all the way back down. We flip our toes, pressing ourselves up, and then pressing back. The spot right in between our two thumbs. Step. Knee come up to meet hands. Inhale, flat back. Exhale, we bring ourselves down and over again. Inhale, we sweep ourselves up to standing. Exhale, hands move down to heart center. Inhale, arms sweep up. Men's, they're so basic. Exhale, we bring ourselves down and over the top. Inhale, flat back. Exhale, hands come back down to our mat. Step back into plank. We press back to our heels, shifting ourselves forward. We lower all the way down, and then lift ourselves up into a forward-facing dog. Pressing down into the tops of our feet. I like to kind of shift back and forth, kind of move around on the tops of my feet, hips in this one. Before we roll over our toes simultaneously, just back. Spotting right in between our thumbs. Step with what you don't normally step with. Step. Feet come up to meet hands. Inhale, flat backs. Exhale, we let ourselves fall. Inhale, sweep ourselves up to standing. Exhale, hands move down to heart center. All right, let's do another moon flow. Inhale, arms move up overhead. Exhale, hands move down to heart center. One more time, inhale, arms move up. Exhale, ground down. Last one, inhale, arms sweep up. Interlock your fingers the opposite way you did last time. Reach up to the sky, big inhale here. Let's move ourselves over to the left side first this time. Big inhale. Taking that left armpit forward, right hip comes forward. Ground down through all four corners of your feet. Big inhale. Exhale, hold. One more time, big inhale. Exhale, we bring ourselves back to center. Go ahead and heel toe our feet apart. Coming into that goddess posture again. Knees pointed over our toes. Again, right? Pull up and in, but still relax and release. Inhale up. Exhale. Inhale up. Exhale. We go for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, for belly is still pulling in to protect low back. Micro bend in that knee, and then we slowly bring that hand down to shin, and then hand comes up to the sky. Big inhale, holding here, and exhale, hold. One more time, big inhale, exhale. Let's turn ourselves down towards the mat. Little foot, back foot hops up just a little bit.
Chin tucks way in towards our chest again. Forehead comes down to our knee. We put as much of a bend in our knees as we need to, but our forehead comes down to touch our knee first. And then we work to straighten out through our legs by pulling up, letting our hips kind of pull up to the sky, but pressing down through our feet. Nice deep inhale. And exhale. Time, big inhale. Exhale. Let's go ahead and drop that foot back behind us, coming into a runner's lunge.
Shifting forward with that shin, pressing out through that heel. Big inhale. And exhale, hold. One more time, big inhale. And then exhale. Go ahead and shift and pivot. Make sure that knee isn't over that, but those hands can come in the front part of, or up to the inside of that left foot. And you can flex that toe back here. You can play around with this one too if you want to try to keep it straight. But that, the front part of that shin, you have that option. Nice deep inhale.
kind of release into this one. This is also a really great one to do at home. Back your heels, like all the way up to the wall, and then kind of use the wall of that space. Take that left armpit towards me.
Come on, Rose, don't you get me? Don't you go?
And pull back with your arms.
Please come on, go.
Yeah, big inhale. Exhale, come back to the center. Hands come down to your heart center. Beautiful job, ladies. Inhale, arms sweep up. Exhale, we bring ourselves down and over the front part of our thighs. Inhale, hands to shins.
Nice to meet you.
Exhale, hands come down to the mat. Step back into plank. And then we're just going to drop down to our knees. And then bring our sit bones back towards our heels. Inhale, arms sweep up overhead.
Come on,
our exhale, we're going to pull in on our low bellies. So bring our pinkies, trying to come down.
Please come on,
modified and extended embryo pose. Head hang right in between our shoulders. Pulling back through our hips. Big inhale. And exhale, hold. One more time, big inhale. And exhale. And then on our next inhale, that low belly, so let your abdomen exhale, hands come down to our sides.
Only wanna
let's
talk,
go ahead,
make it tough,
come down onto our seats, and we'll come into
just
a wide legged trap
stretch.
So in this one, my teacher's name is David Vendetti.
Won't you let me take you
officially a dancer. But so he always is, you know, and he's very charismatic. So he's like, you know, do one of these, like, and you can essentially like scoot yourself all the way like across like the room type of thing, right? So just thinking about it's like a scooch and a shift, and a scooch and a shift, right? So hands come out in front of us, and then we slowly walk our fingertips out in front of us. Again, we lead with our hearts. So we come into this with a nice flat back. I think a lot of times we're like, oh, I just like really want to get my head down here, right? Like we, as humans, like we've been very much programmed to lead with our minds rather than lead with our hearts, because again, like everything has been written by men, but women lead with heart and men lead with their mind. So the great thing is that how to find the balance in the two, right? So a nice deep inhale. Exhale, we pull ourselves down just a little bit more. And again, this is one that you can play with a little bit, right? So you can point your toes or flex your toes one way or another. Nice deep inhale. Last one, big inhale.
butterfly. Then again, you can kind of move around to find out where your sit bones are. Sitting up nice and tall, nice deep inhale. Exhale. And don't think about your knees dropping down to the ground in this one. Visualization in this one is you want your feet, remember, to be ground down through our bones. So you think about your femur bones dropping down to the earth. So think about that big release. Big inhale. And exhale.
Drop over to that opposite side, looking out past our right fingertips this time, trying to keep our knees and our ankles stacked. Nice deep inhale. So twisting and releasing anything that we might still be holding on to on our midline. Nice deep inhale.
Might be an old toothbrush.
know, it might be a belief or an old story that we tell ourselves about ourselves. She had any when they call her working on the bachelor. No, you got a pass, I got a pass, it's in the back of us. Average, I'ma make a million on the average. Riding with no brain, how I'm out of this slide on all your eyes like this. Do you try on all your nights like this? Taking that time to come into space. Soul sessions I was listening to. She said, what is that space? He said, that space is me. Okay. I think it's important for us to remember that that space of ease, the space that just is all of us. So thinking about holding that space of ease, that space of love, the space where there isn't a question, and then the space that where there is no struggle. Doing these sessions with my friend Marlene and having these conversations about the craziness that's been happening recently in the world, but that has been happening, right? I think that there's something really important